To start with the CAM profile, okay, so first we have drawn this base circle. It is given that base circle radius is 50 mm, so the diameter of this base circle is 100 mm. After that, I have drawn one more circle over here, which you can see. Its diameter is 130 mm. Why it is 130 mm? Because we have a roller diameter as 30 mm. Okay, so because of that, we have to draw a circle, base circle plus roller diameter, that is 100 plus 30 mm. So this diameter of the circle is 130 mm. And I have drawn axis of the shaft, axis of the follower from the center of the camshaft. This vertical line represents the axis of the follower. And wherever this vertical line intersect with the outer circle, from that center we draw a roller follower. Okay, so this is the circle of the roller follower. Its diameter is how much? 30 mm. So this is the roller diameter of the follower. As we discussed, the cam is rotating in the anti-clockwise direction, that is in the counterclockwise direction. In this direction, we need to draw the cam profile in the clockwise direction. So we have to mark these angles, that is rise stroke, dual stroke and return stroke in the clockwise direction. So I am going to mark the angles in the clockwise direction now. So next, as I said, we have divided the angles in the clockwise direction. The 48 degree is the outward stroke or the rise of the follower. Next 42 degree we have a dual period, and the next 60 degree we have a return stroke. First, this 48 degree will be divided into 64 number of parts, and this is 60 degree will be divided into 64 number of parts, and the remaining is a full completely dual period. We will divide this 48 into 60 number of parts, and this 60 degree into 60 number of parts. So, as I said, I have divided this 48 degree into 60 number of parts, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and this 60 degree into again 60 number of parts, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Next, what I have to do, I am going to name these points now. Okay, on the outer circle, I am going to name these points. So, on the outer circle, wherever these radial lines are intersecting, for those points, I am going to name them. Starting from here, okay. So I have named these points on the outer circle is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and on the return stroke, starting from 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. Okay. Next thing what I need to do, I have to transfer these points now. That is 1, 1 dash, I have to transfer. Okay, so 1 1 dash I have to transfer on this line. 1 1 dash 1 is here, 1 dash I have to transfer. 2 2 dash is there, so point 2 is there, 2 dash I have to transfer. 3 3 dash, so 3 is there, 3 dash I have to transfer. Like this, I have to do it for 1 1 dash, 2 2 dash, 3 3 dash, 4 4 dash, 5 5 dash, and 6 6 dash. Similarly, I have to transfer these points from the return stroke also, 6 6 dash, 5 5 dash, 4 4 dash. These distances I have to transfer on these radial lines, that is 6 6 dash, 5 5 dash, and 4 4 dash, 3 3 dash. I have to transfer on these radial lines. Okay, so I am going to transfer these distances now. So, students, here you can see I have transfer those points on the cam profile, 1 1 dash, 2 2 dash, 3 3 dash, 4 dash, okay, 5 dash, 6 dash on the base of the follower, that is on the outward stroke, and on the return stroke also I have transferred the point 6 dash, 5 dash, 4 dash, 3, 3 dash, 2, 2 dash, and so on. Next, on these points I am going to draw the roller of the follower, okay, roller diameter I am going to draw now on all these points, okay, on all these points I am going to draw the roller diameter. Okay, as I said, on those points we need to draw the roller of the follower, okay. So here I have drawn with the center of each of these points, I have drawn the roller followers, that is the rollers of the followers from each of these points what we have transferred, that is 6 dash, 5 dash, 4 dash, 3 dash, 2 dash, 1 dash. On these points I have drawn the roller of the follower, and similarly on the return stroke also, on 6 dash, 5 dash, 4 dash, and so on, these are the centers of the roller of the follower. Okay, next what I need to do, I have to draw the smooth curve, okay, starting from this base circle which passes through the tangent to the these circles, roller of the followers, that line should be tangent to the these circles, okay, it should not come to the center point of the rollers, it should pass through tangent to the circles, okay, like that with a freehand sketch I need to draw the profile of the camera passing through tangent to these circles, okay, I have to draw the smooth curve.
So this is the profile of the camera, very gently we have drawn this curve passing through the or taking through these circles, okay. So you have to draw the freehand sketch for this smooth curve, you need to draw passing through these circles, taking through these circles, okay. And this is completely dual curve of the camp. So this is the camp profile picture for the given problem, okay. And we have the velocity and acceleration calculations remaining, that is finding the maximum velocity and acceleration of the follower during the descent. Okay, for this we have a formula. First I will show you the formula. So according to the given question, we need to find the maximum velocity and acceleration of the follower during descent, that is during the return stroke. Okay, so for this we have a list of formula. So for uniform acceleration retardation motion, what we have for the return stroke, and during the acceleration we need to find maximum velocity and acceleration, okay. So from this we need to select the formula, okay. For the return stroke during descent we have a maximum velocity in this equation and the maximum acceleration as this equation. Means during descent we have a uniform acceleration and retardation motion. So through this uniform acceleration and retardation motion we are selecting for return stroke this VD and AD formula, okay. That is velocity during descent and acceleration during descent, okay. So based on this formula we will be finding the velocity and acceleration during descent. So here we have the calculation. So maximum velocity of the follower during descent, that is Vd is equal to 2 omega s divided by theta d. This is the formula. So we need to find omega. Omega is 2 pi n by 60. Speed of the follower is given as speed of the cam is given as 360 rpm. So that is n value. So substituting n we get omega is 37.704 radian per second. So this is the angular velocity of the cam.
Next, the retardation angle, that is descent phase, is given as 60 degree, that we are converting in terms of radians by multiplying pi by 180. So we get it as 1.05 radian. Next, substituting the parameters in this formula, to calculate the maximum velocity of the follower during descent. So it is 2 into omega value is 37.70 per radian per second, and the scope we have substituted in terms of meters, that is 41 is in terms of meter is written as 0.04 meter, that is 40 divided by 1000, and divided by theta d in terms of radian size 1.05 radian, and we get maximum velocity of the follower during descent as 2.873 meter per second. Next, we have maximum acceleration of the follower during the descent phase. So AD is equal to 4 omega square into S divided by theta d square. So 4 omega value we have substituted, so it is omega square into stroke in terms of meter 0.04 divided by theta d in terms of radians 1.05 square. So we get acceleration as 206.31 meter per second square. So this is the solution for the given problem, where we have drawn a cam profile and we calculated this maximum velocity and acceleration of the follower during descent phase. So this is the solution for the given problem, and these are the calculations which are involved in the problem, and this is the cam profile workflow. Okay, thank you.